Well, Sunday's mass shooting in Vegas is a chilling reminder that violence and tragedy can strike at any time. Would you know what to do if you were suddenly thrust into an active shooting scene? We welcome FBI Special Agent Arnold Latinui to Wake Up Today for some, hard to say tips, but on ways to stay alive.
Right.
Good morning to you, Arnold. Thanks for being here. What are the things that we can do? And there are different scenarios, obviously.
Right.
But what can we do off the top when it comes to active shooter?
Well, the FBI promotes a protocol that is developed with other law enforcement agencies known as run, hide, fight. Now, exactly what does that mean? Right. It means, first, you've got to evacuate the area as quickly as possible. Run out of that area. Leave your personal belongings behind. Don't take any personal items, and don't have anything in your hands. Now, a lot of folks might be wondering, like, why not have anything in your hands? It's because law enforcement officers are trained to respond to that area as quickly as possible, and looking for things in your hands is one of the ways that we try and determine who a shooter is and who a non-shooter is. And even though you might have a purse, that's just a split second of time that the officer has to spend trying to discern what it is that you have. Are you the shooter? Are you a victim? And then moving on. And in a mass shooting type situation, when you have a lot of people moving, that kind of delays the response. Now, second step, hide. What does that mean? That means that if you cannot evacuate the area quickly, or if your exit might take you into harm's way, what you should do is find a place to hunker down and sequester yourself. Secure yourself as quietly and safely as possible. That means preferably finding your way behind a locked door and barricading that door with any items that you may have, whether it be furniture, whether it be large office equipment, anything you may have to put some items between you and the bad guy. It also means that you turn off the lights, that you silence your cell phones, and you remain as quiet and calm as possible, knowing that law enforcement is on its way to rescue you. Now, in that rare situation, when there is no other resort, when imminent danger is facing you, fight is the last option that you may have. That means that if you're with a group of individuals, as a group, you band together and you make the commitment that we are going to be fighting for our lives. Improvise weapons with whatever you may find around you, and only at if there's no other option. If, again, once again you're facing imminent danger, only then would we recommend that you go ahead and you fight that assailant.
Only then do you confront.
That's right.
And fight for your life. The scenario, obviously, different in Las Vegas. It was an open field. The gunman was literally a sniper from above.
Right.
Is there anything that they could have done, and I don't want to say differently because it was just a random act and they reacted. What could people do in that kind of a scenario?
Well, at this point in time, we're still recommending that run, hide, fight scenario. Now, certainly this is an unusual event that took place, both in the number of casualties as well as in the unusual positioning of that shooter. However, the protocol run, hide, fight is still the protocol that we're advocating.
Well, Arnold, thank you very much. And these little tips, I mean, you should always think about something, whatever venue you're at, correct?
That's right, absolutely.
And looking for exits and everything else.
Absolutely. Remaining vigilant about your circumstances and being prepared in the sense that whenever you enter one of these large venues, whether it be a restaurant and whether it be an active shooter situation or even a fire that takes place, finding a first primary exit and then a secondary exit, having that in your mind as you enter these venues is a safe thing to do.
It's sad that we've come to that point, but it's
absolutely
true. It's what we have to do as a community. Arnold, thank you very much.
Ron, thank you for having
us. Thank you for your good work.
Thank you.
The FBI does a great job informing us and keeping us safe. When we come back, we're going to check on your surf and your weather forecast, but right now we want to